Dedication is what makes you repeat things in a different manner, flowing, bringing old and new valuables to the surface. This is why I work in series 100 pieces. Now I'm going to introduce you to the first forms of the non-material series. These are paintings, oil on canvas, depicting scenes on the border between abstraction, realism, and our dreamy, ghost-like paintings. The pieces I will show you were never exhibited in public. I started them in 2007 in Munich. And when I was moving my art studio from Munich to London, I decided to send them to my art studio here in Bulgaria. Why? Because the studio here is at the forest, near a lake and a waterfall, and this scenery is the catalyst for these artworks. With the upside down figures, I like to sparkle interest and challenge the viewer's mind. The subject is not important, but your attention to it is. While working on this series, I had a visit from a friend with their family, and we were having dinner in one of the rooms. Their son, around 6 years old, went to the other room and we heard a tremendous noise. I immediately ran into the other room, and what happened is the boy was trying to see the artworks in not inverted state, so he fell on his head. And this is the controversy: the perfection in the surreal figures and the disorder in perception. To put something auf dem Kopf in German means to put it on its head, but in English it means even more: to create a mess, confusion and or a whirl. It is changing our set ways of seeing this and yet freeing them to experience the new and feeling empowered at the end. The images appear flat, poster-like, because of the water prism. But also the repetition causes a wallpaper look. In my childhood, I was sitting in front of my grandparents' house on sidewalk, and I was painting, looking at people going down the street, up the street, down the street, up the street. For me, they were looking like actors on stage, like the puppets in a theater playing box. The people in the painting are walking in one line path. I was playing with what was available to me. I found these beige packaging boxes. They move in only one path. It's the only possible path they have. If we take this symbolically in life, you have only one way, the right way. And sometimes they can decide to run on one path, like this. And that's how they can, this is how they can walk. So imagine these surreal settings and imagine these trees like curtain for the stage. And you see these trees, they don't have roots, they don't have tops, they appear very thin and unstable for their length and flexible like waves, like a fabric, like a curtain in the bedroom, or like the waves caused by the fabric, the trees, or maybe the water prism. These two non-material artworks depict the mirrored in the water image of forests and people. Their clothing appears theatrical, but yet not representing a specific historical period. The paintings are sensitively handled, rather fantastical scenes where figures float in wooded landscapes. This is how Dr. Stephen Klee described them in 2010. They could be a metaphor for a bedroom light, a spotlight behind the forest, atmosphere, quiet, a moving scene. Trees, like curtains of a scene, in eternity in a moment, timeless moments of sweet tranquility, dreams, the perfect setting, the reflection in the water, like a double stage, the water turns to a mysterious mirror, accommodating the stillness of the current. We are left not knowing, is it summer or fall? Темата последната, над която работя, е нон-материал. Това означава, че предимството на картините пред снимките, да кажем, или пред реалността е, че може да се измислят неща и може да се представят неща, които не съществуват, неща, които не могат да се докоснат. Всичките тези картини имат отделни подтеми и изобразяват различни сюжети и като човешката фигура непрекъснато по някакъв начин присъства в тях. Техниката общо взето е почти акварелна. Оставям водата така, да се каже, да се разпростира из моята картина или течността, терпентин с боите. И те понякога сами си определят пътищата, като аз само ги насочвам или ги контролирам по някакъв начин. Следващата ми изложба ще бъде в Нью-Йорк, следващата пролет. Започнахме да говорим за изложбата в февруари 2007. Предишните ми изложби са били в Вила Кото, в Дюселдорф, в Билефелд, в Мюнхен, в Арт Студио. И така започнах тези картини и тази, която в момента виждате, в 2007 година. Като я завърших преди две седмици, тук в България, започнах я в Мюнхен.